welcome back. And if you tuned in late, my very special guest is Pastor George Moore. And we're talking about love. And as we enter into this wonderful time of the year with Thanksgiving and Christmas and hopefully reunions and families together, we need to stop and think about love. And what all of this really is about the ultimate love.
The ultimate love, yes, which is God. The reason that the Apostle John gives God the name of love is that he had seen the apostle, and all the apostles seem to agree with him in their writings. They had observed love working through Jesus Christ. They had seen the very power of love, how it had raised the love of God that raised him from the dead, because God loved us so much and loved him. But he let him go through the suffering that had to take place in order for him, for Christ to accomplish what he came here to do, which was to suffer on the cross. Which it leads us to realize that a love has a dimension of suffering in it. It's not all about feelings and feeling good and comfort and pleasure. It's about suffering. And one of the things that we suffer in so often as we seek to live a life of love is we suffer in the whole process of learning to humble ourselves for others. Humbling ourselves for others. In the world that we live in today, and so much of all that people hear and watch is all about meism. It's all about the huge ego of mankind, which, you know, many believe that mankind is God, that there's no power greater than us. Many believe that. And so they honor themselves more than they honor anyone else.
Now, you talked about love is a commitment.
Yes.
And then during the break, you were talking and you said love is risky.
It is risky because to love someone, they may not love you back. They may love you for a time, and then they begin to act differently towards you. And it's risky for you to remain faithful to love that person. It is, there's lots of evidence to prove the healing power of love. That though a person may fall out with you over something, that if you will continue loving them, not in a manner as we hear it advertised all the time, that love feels good and so on, but in a manner of commitment. You commit yourself to love that person because that's the right thing to do as Christ loved us. Often, there's good evidence to show the power of that love that's being expressed towards another, how it transforms that other person.
Now, you said love
has to
be renewed.
Has to be renewed. You can't just go through the world and say, I love you, like the old story where the wife felt terrible because her husband never said to her he loved her. And he says, well, my goodness, I told you when we got married I loved you. And that was all he was ever going to say it, is the end of the story. Love has to be renewed, and that's why God created the Sabbath for mankind, that mankind could renew their relationship with God. The Sabbath is a day of rest to focus upon the goodness of God in our lives. It is also a day to renew your relationship with family,
With your friends. Children?
Yes, yes. It's not a day where you sit around and you can't do this and you can't do that. It's a day where you, whatever you do no longer as a way of earning money or to better your position, but that Sabbath day is a day of rest where you focus upon God and the good things that He has put in your life, and you have fun. Sabbath is fun. Now, that's a message that many people are hearing, as we hear, because in our stressful world, it's hard to renew love if you stay in the orbit of the world that we live in. You got to get out of that and be intentional about renewing your love relationship. And it's lots bigger than going to Disney World.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot bigger than going to the beach and spending all your time playing with your toys and that kind of thing. That doesn't renew us at the level of love that people want to experience. They want presence. Love is presence. To be present with someone.
Time.
Time.
Give time to
time.
Your children.
And
time to the people
attention.
Who are important to you.
And absolute attention.
Yeah.
See? I mean, I'm not present with my wife when she's talking to me and I'm watching ball game. See?
Yes.
Now, I may be hearing what she says. I may be looking at her from time to time. I'm not present. You're present with people when you love them enough to give away your agenda to be with them and to hear their agenda, what it is that they want, what it is they are hurting about, what it is they're longing for. And that's what, throughout the Church of Jesus Christ, people are crying out for somebody to take the time to be present with me, to listen to me, honestly listen. And very few people listen anymore. It's hard work.
So this is how we should approach this sacred, wonderful season of the year.
I think
well,
so.
Thanksgiving
and every
and the holidays,
no, every
Christmas.
Day of the year.
But I'm thinking as we enter into this
is a good
it's kind
time.
Of a frantic time of the year
yes.
for most of us. This is a way we have to remember
and we
to
can
pull
begin
back
something
and make
new.
Time for
yes.
love.
Yes. If we'll be intentional in this frantic season of the year and pull back and find time to be present with each other and to get out of that frantic world, if we can do it in this next couple of months, most people will find it such a joy, they'll continue doing it for the rest of the year.
Yeah. And the things you do don't have to be expensive. You can take a walk as a family.
That's one of the most loving things to do.
Things
That's
like
one
that.
Of the most loving things to do.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can sit on the porch. As I said to you earlier, I'm amazed at how many people own two homes and never have time or take the time to sit on the porch of either one of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because we're always doing and got to be doing and got to be doing. I was invited to a home recently, and they wanted us to come over to visit,
Mm-hmm.
And so when she called us for dinner, she said, I've done the simplest thing I know to do. She had some bread, she had some butter, she had some peanut butter, and she had soup for everybody. What else you need? You need one other thing, a little jelly for the peanut butter and the bread.
And that's what you had.
And that's what we had, and we had the greatest
But
business.
You had fellowship
oh,
and time.
Gosh. And she did so too, you see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
So we got a lot to learn about love. It's the most powerful force on earth. Love will heal you of all your diseases. When the Bible says that, you got to understand. That's a powerful statement.
And as we close, I just want to thank Pastor George Moore. And I want to say that we wish you love at this special time of the year.